The integers are the numbers 1, 2, 3 and so on together with the negatives and 0. Thus the set of integers is the negatives, 0 and the positive integers. You can see here that the natural numbers, that is the positive integers, are greater than 0, the negative integers are less than 0, when 0 is neither positive nor negative. With 0, the natural numbers are known as the whole numbers. The fractions or decimal numbers are not integer or whole number. Integers are the rational real numbers. When integers are added, subtracted, or multiplied, the result is always an integer. For example, 5 plus 6 is equal to 11, 7 minus 18 equals minus 11, 3 times 2 equals 6. There are three general facts regarding the multiplication of integers. The product of two positive integers is a positive integer. For example, plus 2 times plus 3 equals plus 6, where plus 6 is a positive integer. The product of two negative integers is a positive integer. For example, minus 2 times minus 3 is equal to plus 6. The product of a positive integer and a negative integer is a negative integer. If we consider a positive integer plus 2 and a negative integer minus 3, then we can get plus 2 times minus 3 is equal to minus 6, which is a negative integer. When integers are multiplied, each of the multiplied integers is called a factor or divisor. For example, 2, 3, 10. If we consider, then we can get that 2 times 3 times 10 equals 60. Therefore, 2, 3, and 10 are the factors of 60. Similarly, the integers 4, 15, 5, 12, 1, 60, 3, 20, 6, 10 are also the factors of 60. Therefore, the positive factors of 60 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10, 12, 15, 20, 30, and 60 itself. The negative of these integers are also the factors of 60. For example, minus 6 times minus 10 is equal to 60 as well. There are no other factors of 60. Thus, 60 is a multiple of each of these factors, and that 60 is divisible by each of its divisors. Now, if we consider number 25, we can see that 25 is a multiple of only 6 integers or 6 factors or 6 divisors. Here, 1, 5, 25 and their negatives, minus 1, minus 5, minus 25, all these 6 integers are the 6 factors or 6 divisors of 25. On the other hand, the list of multiples of 25 has no end. Starting from 25, 50, 75, 100, 125, and so on, for all of which 25 is a divisor. Likewise, every non-zero integer has few factors and many multiples. That is, 25 has only few factors, that is 6 factors or 6 divisors, and many multiples. We have to know that 1 is a factor of each integer, but 1 is not multiple of any integer except 1 and minus 1. On the other hand, 0 is a multiple of each integer, but 0 is not a factor of any integer except 0 itself. Least common multiple. The least common multiple of two non-zero integers a and b is the least positive integer that is a multiple of both a and b. For example, the least common multiple of 30 and 75 is 150. This is because the positive multiples of 30 are 30, 60, 90, and so on, and the positive multiples of 75 are 75, 150, 225, and so on. Thus, the common multiples of 30 and 75 are 150, 300, and 450, and so on. And the list of these common multiples is 150. Therefore, the least common multiple of 30 and 75 is 150. The least common multiple is the smallest or least number that will divisible by both of the numbers. That is, if we consider 30 and 75, then it is the smallest number that contains both 75 and 30 as factors, and the number is a multiple of both of these values. Therefore, it will be the smallest number that contains every factor in these two numbers. If we take the factors of 30 and 75, we can write that 30 equals 2 times 3 times 5 and 75 equals 3 times 5 times 5. Here, 30 has one copy of the factors 2, 3, and 5, and 75 has one copy of 3 and two copies of 5. Since least common multiple must contain all factors of each number, the least common multiple must contain all two copies of 5 and one copy of 2 and one copy of 3 in order to be divisible by both 30 and 75. Therefore, the least common multiple of 30 and 75 equals 2 times 3 times 5 times 5 is equal to 150, which is the least common multiple of 30 and 75 that we have obtained earlier. Greatest common divisor or greatest common factor. The greatest common divisor of two non-zero integers a and b is the greatest common integer that is a divisor of both a and b. For example, the greatest common divisor of 30 and 75 is 15. This is because the positive factors or divisors of 30 are 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 10, 15, and 30 itself. And the positive divisors or factors of 75 are 1, 3, 5, 15, 25, and 75 itself. Thus, the common positive divisors or factors of 30 and 75 are 1, 3, 5, and 15. Therefore, the greatest of these common positive factors is 15. In other words, is the number that contains all the factors common to both numbers. In this case, the greatest common divisor is the product of all the factors that 30 and 75 have in common. If we take the factors of 30 and 75, we can see that here 30 and 75 both have one factor of 5, but 75 has a second copy of 5, but 30 does not. So only count is the one copy for obtaining greatest common factor or greatest common divisor. The numbers also share one copy of 3. We cannot also consider 2 because 30 has one copy of 2 but 75 does not. So the greatest common divisor or the greatest common factor of 30 and 75 equals 3 times 5 equals 15, as we have obtained earlier, which is the divisor of both 30 and 75. The product of least common multiple and greatest common divisor or greatest common factor of two numbers is the same as the product of the numbers themselves. Therefore, we can write that number 1 times number 2 is equal to least common multiple times greatest common factor. If we consider the two numbers 30 and 75, then we can write that 30 times 75 equals the least common multiple times the greatest common factor. As we have obtained, the least common multiple of 30 and 75 equals 150. Then we can write that 150 times greatest common factor equals 30 times 75, which results in the greatest common factor or the greatest common divisor of 30 and 75 equals 15, as we have obtained earlier. Thanks for watching. Persevere, practice. Do not forget to like, subscribe, and share. Thanking you from High Study Prep.